this song tutorial, I want to show you how to make a dog drying coat or a towel with a hood. There are so many tutorials on hooded best towels for babies, but I didn't find any tutorial on hooded towels for dogs. So I hope this video will be very useful for you if you are a dog's owner, or you can make it as a gift for your favorite dog's owner, right? Let me tell you why a special bath towel for your dog will be so handy. Your pet won't shake it off because it has a strong Velcro closure. I will show you how to sew Velcro. The towel will really help to prevent water dripping all over the house. It's easy to put it on the dog and the dog will not get annoyed by it because it's lightweight and doesn't prevent the dog from moving. The dog will stay warm while drying. The towel will absorb the water fast, making drying your pet easy. And the towel is great for grooming and traveling and will keep your dog warm, cozy and comfortable. And this hooded towel looks adorable. The hood isn't really that useful for drying the fur, but it's probably more a gimmick for the owner than the dog, especially if you choose to add an applique or embroidery on it, as I did. By the way, if you would like to get the PDF drawing of my applique, it's a unicorn, check out my blog hbury.com. I will put the link to the PDF right under this video. What you will need: bath towel, 100% cotton, thin fabric for biting, regular sewing tools, scissors, threads, needles, pins, sewing machine, of course. What size of the towel to use? Well, it depends on your dog size, but I think the larger the towel, the better. For my 60-pound dog, I use a bath towel 30 inches by 58 inches. I think it's important to choose 100% cotton. It absorbs water better, it's pleasant to the touch. The fabric can be of different densities. I used thick, double-sided, terry cloth towel. Step 1. First, I make a pattern on vellum paper. I just draw it freehand. It looks like this. You can make the same pattern and here is the description. AB and CD equal 20 inches. AD and BC 28 inches. Line AG 9 inches. GE 5 inches, BF 16 or 17 inches, and line AH 8 inches. Just connect points AF and FD with curved lines. Round the lines slightly around the point F so there is no sharp corner in the point F. The line AD is the center on fold. Make a separate pattern for the hood. Step 2. Cut the towel using this pattern. One main piece on fold and one piece for the hood. I used only one towel for cutting the two pieces. Have in mind that when you cut terry cloth fabric, you will have lots of little fuzzy bits. You cannot avoid that. All those little fuzzy cuts from the pile will fly around and go everywhere. Clean the table right away or keep the vacuum cleaner handy. Usually I go outside and give it a good shake so all the small bits go away.
Thank you. I'm going to make binding from this nice shiny stretchy fabric. First of all, I have to cut it straight. So I have this very nice cutting board with lines. I can align this folded edge with this line. And now take my quilting ruler. It also has marks, 1 inch marks, so it will be very easy to cut straight. Look, I place it like this. Well, I can move it a little bit down, so I don't cut too much. Okay, now you use my rotary cutter. I will cut piece that is not straight. See how straight is this edge. Okay, now I need to cut 3 inches because I want my binding to be 3 inches. How do we do that? 3 inches line. And cut. Okay, here I have a strip of fabric for binding. And I need to cut 3 strips like that, so it will be enough for my project. It's a little bit stretchable, so it can even curve a little bit. Again, 3 inches mark. And cut. Now it cut well. And now another one. Okay, now I have 3 pieces like that, 3 inches wide, and I will double fold it for my binding.
If you will use stretchy fabric for binding as I did, you can cut it perpendicular to the selvedges. But if you choose not stretchy woven fabric like quilting cotton, for example, you will have to cut bias strips because the towel has a curved shape, not straight edges. I decided to go with stretchy fabric and cut 3 strips, 3 inches wide. The length is from selvedge to selvedge. It has to be enough to bind the whole towel and the hood. Step 4. Sew the strips together so that the binding is one continuous piece. For this, cut the selvedges first and position 2 strips right sides together perpendicular to each other on a flat surface and align raw edges. You see that the edges of the strips make a right angle. Draw a line with a marker across the pieces to connect the points where they intersect at an angle of exactly 45 degrees. Pin them together and sew along that line. The diagonal seam makes the binding tape less bulky and less noticeable than a straight seam. After that, connect all the strips. Make sure that there is enough length with a margin. Measure the approximate perimeter of the towel, plus about 25 inches to bind the hood. Fold this continuous piece in half lengthwise, wrong sides together, and press. Step 5. Bind the hood on the straight side. Cut from the long binding the length that matches the length of the hood. You should have a long ribbon left for covering the entire perimeter of the towel. Pin the folded binding to the hood. And after that, stitch it with seam allowance 3/8 of an inch or 1 centimeter. Wrap the binding around the edge and pin it so that the binding edge is going a little bit over stitches. Prepare your sewing machine to sew thick terry cloth. Use thicker needle, size 9014 universal. Use strong thread that doesn't break easily. And make the stitch length around 3 millimeters. Step 6. Put an applique or an embroidery design on the hood piece, and it's completely optional. If you would like to get the printable drawing for the unicorn applique in PDF, go to my blog hbury.com. I will put the link to the PDF under this video. Step 7. Bind the towel with the binding strip. Place the hood on the towel and make sure that all edges are aligned. Pin the hood to the fabric to prevent it from moving. It not only finishes the raw edges of the towel, but also decorates your towel with a beautiful finish. Line up the long raw edges of the binding strip with the raw edge of the towel and pin in place. But I like to use wonder clips to hold the binding in place. You can buy the whole box of them quite cheap, but they are better than pins for thick fabric. And here we have in some places two pieces of double terry cloth together. Sew the binding with 3/8 of an inch or 1 centimeter seam allowances. After you are done, fold it over the raw edge. And begin clipping the binding to the reverse. Work your way around the towel until everything is folded and clipped in place. Make sure the folded edge of the binding strip covers the stitch seam on the reverse of your towel by about 1 millimeter. After that, machine stitch binding in place to finish the towel. In the needle, I put thread that matches my binding fabric, and in the bobbin, I put thread that matches the towel fabric, so the stitches blend right in. Stitch the folded edge of binding on one side of the towel, and on the other side you will have almost an invisible line of stitching. Step 8. Sew Velcro for securing the towel on the dog. For this towel, I used white Velcro strips, 2 inches wide. I made one strip 6 inches long and I cut the other one shorter, about 2 inches long. Before stitching the Velcro to the towel, attach them with fabric glue stick. It will help to sew them easily. Here is the result. If you like this tutorial, check out my other video sewing tutorials and subscribe to my channel. Also, check links under this video.